Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. We're talking about coordinate systems, and today we're talking about intercepts. And intercepts are a really important concept in graphing, and we're going to be using them a lot, so it's nice to talk about the intercepts. Probably the one we talk about the most is the y-intercept. If we have a graph, and we have a graph of a linear equation, that's a picture of the solutions, remember, if where it crosses the y-axis, is its y-intercept. So a y-intercept is just where the graph crosses the y-axis. And we abbreviate y-intercept with the lowercase letter b. Okay? Then we have an x-intercept. An x-intercept is where the graph would cross the x-axis. So those two points that fall onto the axes, those are the two intercepts. The x-intercept is abbreviated with the letter A. So take a look at, let me just give you a couple more things about the intercepts here. Every y-intercept, which we could call B, is on the y-axis. And since you don't go left or right to plot them, because you don't go left or right, you just go straight up or straight down, then the x value has to be zero. So when you look at an intercept, a y-intercept, you know that your x has to be zero. It has to be zero because we don't go left or right. We just go straight up or straight down. So when I see a point with a zero in it, I know it's an intercept. If that x is zero, I know it's a y-intercept. Every x-intercept, which we could call lowercase a, is on the x-axis. And since you don't go up or down to plot them, the y value has to be zero. Notice if we're here, we went backwards, but then we didn't go up or down. We stayed right here. No matter where we go on the x-axis, if we don't go up or down, we're going to be right there on the x-axis. So every x-intercept is on the x-axis, and we don't go up or down. So that means that our y has to be zero. So we could say our x-intercepts are A, zero. Notice that both intercepts have zeros in the opposite place. A y-intercept has an x that's zero, an x-intercept has a y that's zero, and that's explained in these sentences. So in these particular pictures, identify the x-intercept and the y-intercept. I could number them to make them a little more helpful. What about in number one? Where does this graph cross the x-axis? It crosses the x-axis at 2, so the x-intercept is 2, 0. What about the y-intercept? Well, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It crosses the y-axis at negative 5, but we didn't go left or right, so that's got to be 0, negative 5. So the x and y intercepts are those points that cross the x and y axis. And I'm hoping that you can label them, identify them correctly, putting the zeros in the correct place. What's the x intercept for this one? Well, you're going to go 1 over, and then you don't go up or down. So it's 1, 0. Notice all of our x intercepts have a 0 in the y place. What would be the y-intercept here? Well, don't go left or right, but go up 2. So we have 0, 2. What about this one? Well, this is a little different, right? Because we have the point is on the origin. So our x-intercept is 0, 0, because we didn't go up or down or left or right. And that means that we have the same intercept. The x-intercept and the y-intercept are both 0, 0. And that's the one time when they can share the same point because it is just one point. The x and the 0 are both being, both x and the y are both being 0 makes it an origin point. Okay, then the last little piece on this video is to draw a graph where a is negative 2 and b is negative 3. What does a stand for? A is the x-intercept, and what does B stand for? B is the y-intercept. So if I wanted to draw a graph that had an x-intercept of negative 2, I'd have to go to the x-axis and draw negative 2. And go to the y-axis and draw negative 3. Then I could connect those two points to make a graph, to make a line, which just happens to be, the graph is a line, and I could connect those up. And there's a graph where it has an x-intercept of negative 2 and a y-intercept of negative 3. And the point of that was to remind you, we were writing these as ordered pairs, but you can also say the x-intercept is negative 2 or the y-intercept is negative 3 in that format. All right, we'll see you next time.